so that he will not destroy the fruit of your ground, nor shall the vine fail to bear fruit for you in the field. In other words, what you are working on, your mind, your vineyard, your job, your career, your business, whatever it is, he said it won't fail to bear for you. It may fail to bear for everybody else around you. But because you're a tither, he's saying, I will make sure what you're working on will work for you. Amen. Jesus is the same principle. So look at this, look at the difference. He's saying, you bring that 10% tithe to me, and I'm going to open the windows of heaven for you. What? That's not equal. We're bringing in the 10% of the little old something that we have, one person on the earth, and God Almighty says, I'm going to open the windows of heaven for you. Amen? But you know, it takes faith to do it. It takes faith to do it. And with our actions, we can tell God, I don't believe you. Amen. I don't believe you. Some years ago, the Lord spoke to me very clearly, and he said, many of my people have more faith in what 10% of their income can do for them than what I can do for them. And I thought, that's exactly right. We're deciding, do I believe that this 10% of my income can help me more, or do I believe that God can help me? And by withholding our tithe from the Lord, we're telling God very quickly, I don't trust you. I trust this 10% of my income more than I trust you. This will help me more than that. Let me just give you a little advice. That's not good. That's not good. That's not faith. And see, we put ourselves in a position where we don't receive. In fact, you remember, this is why he told them there in Malachi 3, the 8th verse, will a man rob God? Yet you have robbed me. But you say, in what way have we robbed you, God? In tithes and offerings. You are